IVM.
You are listening to the Kahaaniya podcast. Kahaaniya is a series of open mic storytelling events organized by Tape a Tale. The stories you're about to hear were recorded live. They are told by the people who've lived them. This week, we feature two of these very special and unique tales. Our first story is by Amandeep Singh and is called Imandari ki tikiya.
Zindagi darwaze par khadi hai, par darwaze par kadi hai. Aajkal rukte nahi ek jagah tum, itni kahan ki hadbadi hai. Ye wo ek kissa hai, jo ab mera hissa hai. Ye wo ek kissa hai, jo ab mera hissa hai. मैं थोड़ा जिद्दी किस्म का इंसान हूं. एक बार जो हां कर दी तो हां और ना कर दी तो ना. और इस जिद ने बचपन में मुझे बहुत मार खिलवाई है. लगभग घर के सारे लोग मुझसे परेशान रहते थे. मां तो इस हद तक कि या तो हर दूसरे दिन मुझे झाड़ू से कूटती थी या बातें करना बंद कर देती थी. तो मैं भी थोड़ा चिड़ा चिड़ा सा रहता. पर इन सब रंजिशों के बीच वो एक शख्स जो चुपचाप मेरे साथ खड़ा रहता था और है, वो है मेरे बाबा. हाथ उठाना तो दूर की बात, मुझे तो ये तक नहीं याद कि आखिरी बार उन्होंने मुझसे ऊंची आवाज में बात कब की थी. हूबहू मेरी तरह दिखते हैं वो. जी हाँ, हूबहू मेरी तरह दिखते हैं वो. क्योंकि बाबा हमेशा कहते हैं कि जितना मैं उनसे सीखता हूँ उतना ही वो भी मुझसे सीखते हैं. बाप बेटे के रिश्ते से पहले हमारे बीच दोस्ती का रिश्ता है. जैसे दो दोस्त आंखों ही आंखों में बिना कुछ कहे एक दूसरे के हालात समझ लेते हैं ना, बिल्कुल वैसा. और तो और बाबा मुझे कभी किसी चीज के लिए मना नहीं करते. जब कभी भी मैं उनसे कुछ बोलता, कहीं जाने को कहता या कुछ करने को पूछता, तो वो बस एक बात कहते कि बेटा, अगर तुम्हें ये गलत नहीं लग रहा तो करो. और न जाने कैसे हर बार उनकी इस बात के बाद खुद ब खुद मुझे सही और गलत के बीच का अंतर पता चल जाता. और अगर कभी गलती से कोई भूल हो भी जाती तो बाबा तो हमेशा साथ है ही. तो ये बात तब की है जब मैं क्लास 5 में था. ठीक 1 तारीख को बाबा की तनख्वाह आती और महीने के पहले संडे की शाम बाबा और मैं हम दोनों साथ मिलकर राशन लेने जाते. एक पुरानी सी साइकिल के हैंडल पर 2 झोले बांधकर महीने भर की खुशियां लेकर आते. तो उस रोज जब हम वापस आ रहे थे तो बाबा की नजर झोले के ऊपर रखे हुए विम बार की एक बड़ी टिकिया पर गई. बाबा ने मुझे रुकने को कहा और हिसाब वाला खाता मांगा. कुछ देर उन्होंने उस हिसाब वाले खाते में उस दिन के हिसाब की जांच पड़ताल की और बोले, यार इसने तो छोटी टिकिया का दाम जोड़कर बड़ी टिकिया दे दी. चलो कोई बात नहीं, तुम यहां इंतजार करो, मैं अभी इसे बदलवा कर लाता हूं. तो मैं फट से बोल पड़ा, बाबा ये क्या कर रहे हो, छोड़ दो ना, अभी कहां इतनी दूर वापस जाओगे. तो बाबा एक पल को रुके, जरा सा मुस्कुराए और उस टिकिया को हाथ में लेते हुए बोले, बेटा ये मुझे गलत लग रहा है तो मैं ये नहीं करूंगा. मैं वहां उनका इंतजार करने लगा. कुछ 5-10 मिनट बाद वो उस टिकिया को बदलवा कर एक छोटी टिकिया लेकर आए और हम घर की ओर चलने लगे. रास्ते में बाबा ने एक हाथ से साइकिल को संभाला और दूसरा हाथ मेरे कंधे पे रखते हुए बोले, बेटा ईमानदारी किसी और से नहीं की जाती, ईमानदारी खुद से होती है. ईमानदारी हर उस चीज में होनी चाहिए जिसे आप सच्चे दिल से करते हो. तब जाकर यह समझ में आया कि ईमानदारी सिर्फ पैसों की मोहताज नहीं होती. उस दिन से हर सुबह एक बस्ता उठाए आंखों में सपने लिए बस इसी उम्मीद से घर से निकलता हूं कि अगर किसी दिन जिद छोड़ देता हूं या जिंदगी में किसी मोड़ पर पहुंचकर हार कर थक कर बैठ जाता हूं तो इस बात की राहत हमेशा रहेगी कि बड़ी ईमानदारी से सपने देखे थे और उतनी ही ईमानदारी से उन्हें पूरा करने की कोशिश भी की थी. क्योंकि ये जो ईमानदारी है ना, वो बाबा की वापस लाई हुई इस छोटी टिकिया की तरह है जो गलत नहीं सही है. सपनों के लिए जोश, जज्बा, जुनून, हौसला, हिम्मत, ये सब बहुत जरूरी है. जब तक आप इन सब को पूरी ईमानदारी से नहीं निभाते तब तक कुछ मुकम्मल नहीं होता. तो ईमानदार बनो, दुनिया से नहीं, खुद से, अपने सपनों से.
That was Amandeep Singh. Stay tuned because we have one more great story for you after this break.
Hi, I'm May and I'm a huge fan of the indie music scene in our country. A scene that's
relatively underground, even though it sometimes peeks its head overground. But there's no shortage of talent, and I get the privilege of interviewing some of the most awesome musicians on my show. I've had the likes of Euphoria, Kersh Kale, Hardcore, Randolph Correa. I've had singer-songwriters, folk singers, electronic music producers, playback singers, rappers, fusion artists, instrumentalists, classical musicians, and so on. Whether mainstream or not, these people have chosen to release their original music, and these are the people currently shaping the direction in which our music scene is heading. Join me on my show every Monday and tune in to discover the unique talent coming out of India today. You can catch Made in India on your favorite podcasting app or our very own IBM podcast app.
Welcome back to the Kahaaniya podcast. The next story is by Sylvina Jennifer and is called He Will Never Text Me Back.
So guys, it all started when I was around 10 years old. I met this guy at a wedding in Trichy, and he came up and spoke to me and my brother, and we instantly, you know, became friends, and we spent the entire summer together. We made a lot of memories over that summer. I had my first bicycle ride, I went for my first swim, I watched my first Hollywood movie, and many other fun stuff. But as we grew up, we lost touch, we stopped talking to each other. And fast forward to 2011, I heard that he had moved to Bangalore. So I used my pro FB stalking skills and found him on FB. He had grown his hair long and he was part of this super biking club. And he was so not the person that, you know, I had once liked. But I always had him in mind and of course continued stalking him. So the time came when, you know, marriage talks started coming up in his house, and his parents always had me in their mind. So they approached me, but at that point of time, I was really not ready for a marriage, and the proposal dropped right there. But secretly in my mind, you know, I always wanted to fall. I wanted both of us to fall in love and then marry. Soon they found a bride. And they were engaged, so I just made up my mind that, okay, he's never going to be mine ever. But life took a big U-turn and their engagement broke. I was on cloud nine. I know it's evil, but I was on cloud nine, and I thought, okay, the heavens want us to marry. So around after a year, he gave me a friend request on FB. I accepted it. I played it cool. I never texted him. So after a few weeks, I got a like and a comment on one of my pics. So I commented back, he commented back, and then we started liking each other's posts and whatever we posted, any shit, just like and comment. So eventually it ended up in exchanging numbers. Then we started talking and chatting, and we picked up from where we left, from our childhood days. Of course, he found out and I'm falling for him, and he made it very clear to me, I just want both of us to remain friends. I was friend zone. Yes, girls get friend zone too. So, anyway, so I always knew that, you know, he had feelings for me. I could sense it, but I knew that there was some fear inside him. So he gave it a lot of thought, and one night he spoke to his dad and he told him, you know what, I'm ready for marriage right now, and I want to marry Chili. The very same night, he dropped me a text around 11:30 p.m. and that was one of the nights I went to sleep early. So I really missed that text, and around 12:30 a.m. I woke up, I saw the text. He had asked me, are you awake? So I told him, yeah, I'm awake, but it never got delivered. So I assumed, okay, he must be asleep, and I didn't want to disturb him, and I went back to sleep. So next day was a Sunday morning. I'm a Christian, so I go to church. So I went to church. I just was waiting for the service to get over so that I can switch on my net and see what he had replied. So after the service, as I was walking, you know, all these butterflies in my stomach, and I was calming them down, and I switched on my net, and I saw my brother running towards me, screaming out my name. And from the look on his face, I knew it was not going to be something good. And what he told me turned my world upside down. He told me, Jenny, he met with an accident today morning, and he died on the spot. I just saw my entire world shatter in front of me. I still remember sitting in the back of my car, going to the hospital and just praying the entire way that it must not be him. And I never wanted to see him dead. I never did until his body went to Trichy. And the entire way when the body was taken in an ambulance, I was sitting right behind the ambulance, listening to the siren, looking at the ambulance for 8 straight hours. I didn't shed a drop of tear. I just couldn't believe it. And I was just sitting right in, next to his parents. And once we reached there, I saw him. And that's when his dad told me. The previous night, he called me and told me that he wanted to marry you. And that's the very same reason why he texted me that night. And that's the same reason why he actually went for an early morning ride to meet his friend and talk about it. It still haunts me that I'm never going to get a reply for that text, ever. Anyways, coming to my present, I am happily married right now. So, yeah. I just want to tell, the reason why I wanted to share this story here is I want to tell everybody who's going through any kind of hardships or any kind of breakups or anything, you know, life goes on. Life goes on, no matter what. So even when a storm hits you, just pick yourself up from where you left and build yourself up. And there's no harm in doing that. Thank you.
That was the Kahaaniya podcast. If you have an amazing personal story that you want to share with the world, send in your stories to contact@tapeatale.com or on WhatsApp at 799-202-9939. If you want to dive into some more awesome stories, check us out on tapeatale.com as well as on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram and YouTube at tapeatale.
There she stands, a podcast addict. Outside the bank, having traveled several miles to get in with other poor souls like her. The journey, though daunting for this youngling, will have some comfort because she has downloaded her favorite podcast. You can see more of her species on ivmpodcasts.com. Your one-stop destination where you can check out the coolest Indian podcasts. Happy listening.